Now, before you go out and pull the trigger on a Golf 7 GTI, we're going to cover all the things that you need to know about and common problems that exist with the Golf 7 GTI. Now, the Golf 7 GTI overall is a big improvement over the Golf 6 GTI. There's been many parts and issues that have existed on the Golf 6 GTI that's rectified in the Golf 7 GTI, but there are still common problems that exist with the car. Now, the Golf 7 GTI is built on Volkswagen's new MQB platform, and that is a code name that's being used for all the new Volkswagen and Audi Group's vehicles that's being built. And on the same platform, vehicles will normally share parts across the range. So you might find that a hatchback and a sedan and an SUV shares the same parts, even though the wheelbases are different. And with the Golf 7 GTI, it's built on a completely new platform, which is called MQB. Enough about the history of the Golf 7. Let's get into the common problems that exist on the Golf 7 GTI. Point number one on our list today is the water pump or thermostat leaking water. Now, this is really a wear and tear component. The water pump is constructed out of plastic, and you as the owner of the car, there isn't really much that you can do to prevent the water pump from leaking. It's pretty much a matter of when. That's really the best advice we can give you regarding the water pump leaking. And labor-wise, you're looking at 4 hours to replace the water pump at a dealership, at an OEM dealership or RMI dealership. That's probably what they're going to spend on the car. One thing that you do need to note with the water pump is that it's not plug and play. If you replace the water pump, you also need to bleed the cooling system using VW's diagnostic software afterwards. So just keep that in mind. If you might want to get it done at a non-OEM dealership, just check that the person who's going to replace the water pump for you, that they are capable to bleed the cooling system as well. Point number two on our list today is timing chain wear. Now, the timing chain issues that exist with the Golf 7 GTI are nowhere nearly at the reported rate of the Golf 6 GTI. With the Golf 6 GTI, we had every second, third car had problems with the tensioner and with the timing chain, and it was just a big mess. With the Golf 7 GTI, it's not that bad, and there's also light at the end of the tunnel. So with the Golf 7 GTI, you can actually take the car to VW if you predict or if you think that there's a problem with the timing chain, and they can plug in the diagnostic equipment and they can actually figure out if there's a problem existing, if the chain is wearing. Now, the chain does wear over time, and if it stretches excessively, the timing chain can skip a tooth, and that would obviously cause the timing on the car to go out, and you can hurt your cylinder head, you can damage your valves, you can damage your pistons. There are a couple of catastrophes that can come from the timing chain skipping a tooth, but it's not that common, and there's at least a remedy in place for you to check if there is a problem with the timing chain, if it's stretched. So take it to your local VW dealer, let them do a diagnostics of the car just to check for you, is the timing chain stretched? And yeah, you can even do that as part of doing the multi-point check. So if you're in the market to buy Golf 7 GTI, just pay the dealer extra what they're gonna charge you, hours worth of labor, and let them check out the chain for you. Point number three on our list today is cylinder head valve spring breakage. Now, this is quite crazy because there's not much that you can do as the owner to predict when the cylinder valve springs is going to break or when it's going to break, but you can watch out for the symptoms. So you can watch out for erratic idling, you can watch out for misfires. Now, the construction of the cylinder head is made out of two springs, and the smaller spring inside the cylinder head, over time, it just breaks. So that's really just wear and tear. Luckily, it's not catastrophic. So if the cylinder head valve spring does break, you can simply take it to a workshop, to the OEM dealer. They can inspect the cylinder head for you and they can replace the springs if it's broken. So luckily, you don't have to replace your engine with this problem. Point number four on our list today is dirty fuel injectors caused by carbon buildup. Now, in South Africa, we don't have the highest quality of fuel available at our local garages when you go put in fuel. That is not the best fuel you can buy in the world. And because of that, it causes carbon buildup. Now, the Golf 7 GTI is a direct injection engine. It also uses 8 injectors. So you have 4 injectors inside the cylinder head, and then you also have 4 injectors on top of the intake manifold. Now, over time, the 4 injectors on top of the intake manifold, they get dirty, they build up carbon, and they need cleaning. Luckily, VW, they are aware of this, and they also have a procedure in place to clean the injectors for you, so you don't have to actually replace the injectors. You can just get the injectors cleaned at your local dealership. So if you notice that your car is underperforming, Maybe you got some misfire. Maybe the performance just doesn't feel like it used to. Maybe like a year ago or maybe 6 months ago. You should definitely check your injectors out. Maybe there's some carbon buildup on the injectors and they could be dirty. Now, of course, the Golf 7 GTI, because it's a direct injection engine, you can also have carbon buildup on the cylinder head. So you just need to check that out as well. If you have your injectors clean and it's possible, you might as well get a carbon clean of the cylinder head as well. Point number five on our list today is high pressure fuel pump failure. Now, this is sadly something that I've blown over from the Golf 6 and the Golf 5 GTI. We're not completely out of the hoods, but this is a pretty common problem on GTIs, and it's really just basic to diagnose. You'll find that under wide open throttle, there's not the amount of power that you're looking for, and the car can also cut out while you drive, and that's all related to the fuel supply that's being cut to the vehicle. Now, there isn't really much you can do as an owner to prevent the high pressure fuel pump from failing. If you do identify some symptoms with your high pressure fuel pump, like I've just described now, under wide open throttle, you'll have issues with acceleration, have the car diagnosed, have it checked out, and if it's a high pressure fuel pump, just get it replaced. Point number six on our list today is the electric windows one touch that stop working. Now, this can either be self-inflicted, that's you removing the battery of the car that would cause the one touch electric windows to stop working, or there is a problem with a window regulator. Now, most of the time there's actually a problem with a window regulator, but if you have disconnected the battery, you can actually activate the one touch yourself. You can just roll up the window and then you can just press the button to move the window up three times. So roll up the window, one, two, three. That's how you can reactivate the one touch yourself. That's the easy part. But unfortunately, the regulator is actually the issue that mostly fails. And this is a common problem with the Golf 7 GTI. I actually know somebody personally who had the entire door of the car replaced by VW, because VW themselves, they just couldn't diagnose what was the problem with the one touch on the car. But it's pretty common, so that's something that you need to watch out for. If you're interested in buying a used Golf 7 GTI, get in the car, jump in every seat, and just make sure that the windows can go up by one touch and it can go down. Number seven on our list today is premature wear of the front top shock mounts. Now, you can watch out for squeaky noises when you're turning into the car. When you go test drive one that you're interested in buying, just make sure that you don't hear any squeaky noises that's coming from the front of the car. Normally, if you hear that, it's a problem with the front top shock mounts and they just need to replace. The shock struts itself, the shock construction, it's fine. There's nothing wrong with the shocks. But the front shock top mounts is a weakness on the car and they wear prematurely. VW, they're aware of it. They've had customers come in there 3, 4, 5 times with the same car with the same issue. It's a known problem on the car and this is something you need to watch out for. That's it. That's our list of issues that exist with the Golf 7 GTI. And you know what? It's not that bad. The Golf 7 GTI is actually a solid car. And if you're interested in buying one, I would strongly encourage you to get a used Golf 7 GTI. My name is Kurt from wheelindex.co.za, the place where South Africans shop when they are looking to buy a used car. And if you're looking for a Golf 7 GTI that's used, check out our website. There's a big array of Golf 7 GTIs just waiting for you. Catch you back next time. Cheers.